an angel who fell from the clouds and who tumbled right into a thornberry bush. They yelled out in pain, but I felt real insane watching something so foreign fall down. They called out for help and I couldn't quite tell if I really was finally losing my mind. I took a step forward and one after that, and I slowly approached the unthinkable creature before me. It's there as each and every hair on my body stood up like it's never before. A feeling of might filled the scene of the sight, and the angel itself was no more. Inhumanly sized, it had 20 big eyes, all that caught me in moments and cut through my soul. Its four pairs of wings stuck with all the sharp things, cast its feathers with blood made of gold. No lips to be seen, but its voice could be heard in a rumbling thunder that shook through my head. The day sure changed fast, and I watched it aghast as my heart dropped like 10 pounds of lead. Its three pairs of arms became gored with the fall, and I trembled in fear at the sight of its grace. Its voice thundered loud till it realized the sound wasn't something that humans could face. So it quieted down to a soft little growl as it asked for some help off the thorns in its skin. It cast a strange glow like a fresh coat of snow in the sun on a cold winter day. It held out its arms and I reached my hand out to caress the strange creature conjured from my mind. But it didn't push through, it touched skin cool like dew, and I gasped at this shocking new find. I once saw an angel who fell down from the skies, cause the smoke and mirrors blocked its way and destined it to die. I thought I'd suffer hell if I'd just left this holy thing to perish. So I grabbed onto its hands and I pulled on it to help it stand. A sound of pain tore through my ears. I stuck it through as it drew tears of silver from the piercing eyes that saw right through my life. It took me some patience to bear all the ancient raw power that shone from the creature like light, but I helped the thing up till it finally unstuck, and I truly accomplished the fight. It stood very tall, bloody arms, wings and all, and it looked to meet eyes with a terrified me. It hadn't a mouth, but its eyes were no doubt smiling warm, seeming very relieved. My dear, you gave me back my life, it said. Without your help, I'd surely be dead. So I thank you, little mortal, for the service you've done unto me. It knelt down to my level with its hands against its chest, until they all leaned forward, open-palmed, and gave a gift far above mortal's best. A star in its palms glowed with warmth and with love, and it told me to hold it close when I'm alone, to help me through all of the terrible nights that its star set in my future stone. I once found an angel who was left to crash and burn, and it taught me there's so much left to see and infinite things left to learn. Sometimes I still wonder about if that angel ever made it home, because I kept its star and it warms my soul and it's with me wherever I roam. I once found an angel who was thrown back down to earth, celestial cast away in a mortal place where they've lost all their infinite worth.